Hey guys, my name is Anuradha. Welcome to our channel GE Guidance and Knowledge. Happy morning to all of you. Today we are going to discuss an essay which is Never Let a Good Crisis Go Waste. So let's begin with the introduction. In early 2000s, Jordan was facing a long dry spell and increasing water demand. With limited water supplies, depleting groundwater resources, huge influx of refugees created a crisis that shows public demonstration and conflict among farmers. The government responded with a series of drastic reforms, including a water authority law to stop illegal pumping of groundwater, strengthened enforcement penalties, etc. Together, these rescued a 95% reduction in illegal drilling and water saving of 30 to 40 million metric cube. The above story of Jordan is an example of how a good crisis can lead to better outcomes if these crises are taken as an opportunity. History is replete with examples of how crises can have resulted in a betterment of humanity whenever the crisis has been followed by reforms, programmatic responses, the blocking of trade together. Programmatic responses, the blocking of trade throughout consignment by Arabs, lead the discovery of Cape of Good Hope route. French Revolution became foundation of unification of countries, then decolonization, abolition of slavery, movements for democracy, etc. Then fast forward to ongoing COVID-19 pandemic, which has swept the world in span of few months, has created an unparalleled crisis. The unparalleled nations were taken by surprise and found wanting. What is more serious a question is, did we anticipate such a crisis to hit us? The other question which need answer, like, where do we go from here? Then are we ready to take our lessons forward to not to let a similar situation arise again? Then what has been experiences of human till now in learning from crisis? Let us try to find the answers of each of one of question. In one, the viral stories during the pandemic, COVID-19 pandemic, the TED Talks telecast of Bill Gates, the Microsoft founder, which was seen explaining everyone the next global crisis would not be a nuclear war but a highly infectious virus which has close association in working with Ebola pandemic, then polio eradication. He understood the lack of preparedness of governments to deal with such outbreaks. As a result, what we are witnessing is not a surprise for. As a result, we are witnessing is not a surprise for many experts, as countries did not learn from previous pandemics. The resources toward vaccine making, ensuring robust infrastructure in healthcare sector, global cooperation was not prioritized, which has led to another virus is becoming deadly. The global leaders would do well to increase expenditure in health, including India, which spent nearly 1.5% of GDP. Its GDP want to increase 2.5% by 2025. India has had its own experiences. India had its own experiences with dealing and handling various crises in various fields. In some cases, we have failed to other emerge victorious. At the outset of independence, when the socio-economic indicators was abysmally poor, with limited resources and capital at our disposal, we invested in lying in the foundation of modern India. The various river valley projects like Hirakund Dam, Satluj Dam, various iron and steel plants, IITs and IIMs also emerged from the grave crisis of nation full of deprivation and advertisement. Deprivation and adversities. Adversities. Deprivation and adversities. Further, the food crisis of 1960s laid the foundation of Green Revolution. The balance of payment crisis in 1980s and 1980s to 90 resulted in the bold move of LPG reforms. Liberalization, privatization, globalization reforms. These steps have added bricks to the idea of India economically and socially. In the political sphere, the decade of 2000s was significant in the sense that the lack of physical discipline by the government was tried to be addressed by FRBM Act. The job crisis culminated within MNREGA, which has been able to provide seasonal employment. The period also saw knots of corruption like 2G scam, Colgate scam and Commonwealth scam. The crisis was tried to be addressed from transparent coal and spectrum auctioning. This competition crisis also ultimately resulted in the form of Lokpal Act 2013 to address corruption socially, as well as there has been several good crises which helped in bringing structural changes. The historical discrimination on the basis of untouchability was taken as a lesson by the constitution makers, including safeguards like positive discrimination means reservation for affirmative action to provide a legal playing to a level playing field to vulnerable sections by Bhimrao Ambedkar. In the environmental arena, the industrial pollution has led to climate change, global warming, sea level rise, glacier melting and other crises. With efforts like Montreal Protocol, which help us to reduce the ozone depletion, and many moves like Rio Earth Summit and Paris Climate Agreement, etc., the global community is trying to eliminate further environmental crises. Also, these efforts have shown that good crises can be lead to better cooperation between countries. Do not let it go waste. However, not always have good crises seen appropriate measures taken and they have been wasted. The Hiroshima and Nagasaki episode unveiled the worst phase of nuclear bombs. Humanity didn't learn the lesson. As a result, apart from few piecemeal measures, the countries continues to possess their weapons in the name of deterrence. As a result, the mankind existence is at the brink of nuclear war always. We have failed to build vaccine ever after MERS and SARS. These are other viruses of coronavirus and other deadly diseases rocking frequently in India. India still far behind in health and nutritional aspects, even when we have seen famines and hunger crisis. We are still home for 40 million stunted and 70 million wasted children. Tropical cyclone and other extreme weather events continue to haunt us even now, despite the fact we have numerous of these past. The recent Vizag gas leak as the industrial disaster is nothing new, as we have failed to learn from the previous mistake of Bhopal gas tragedy. In order to successfully diffuse a crisis, to make it an opportunity, an organization or government need to know how to handle the crisis before it actually taking place. Different authors have give different approaches, but the most popular is given by the Gonzale, Herrer and Pratt in early 1996, where they have discussed these stages in crisis management, their diagnosis of crisis planning and for the prevention, and find adjusting to changes where government usually fail. It is when they go for the short term and lacking in the long term measures. Take the care of current weather crisis. The government then opt for river cleaning programs like Namami Gange. They generally focus on the building sewage treatment plant and relating infrastructure. government failed to address the check of sources of their water pollution. And other authors' insights of the crisis management is worth mentioning here. Nasheem Taleb, in his Anti-Fragile, mentioned that something benefits from shocks degrow when exposed to stress, volatility, crisis, risk, and uncertainty. In our personal life, a small stress on income pushes us to save more small fights in relationship, make the bond stronger. In classes case of crisis, it is an opportunity, is from one of our own state, Orisha, which is often ridiculed as a Bimaru state. Orisha was hit by a cyclone in 2000s, which killed 10,000 lives. The state since then have emerged as a lesson for the others to follow. It recently evacuated 1 million people safely during the cyclone Fani. According to United Nations, Orisha zero casualty approach is the major contributor to implementing Shandai framework. Further, in a cyclone Bulbul, Odisha Community Management Cyclone Management Center with the local sarpanch as it is came handy. Bulbul is a cyclone named by Pakistan. At the national level, we need to invest more in research and development, infrastructure funding, building partnerships, sustaining and encourage community efforts at the local level. At the heart of the modern day crisis management life in the crisis preparedness involving anticipation of the potential crisis through an analysis of risk causes and actions that leads to such crisis. At the personal level and societal level, increased empathy and compassion towards our family members, people around us can help to mitigate the crisis of compassion. The pandemic like COVID-19 should bring the change in hygiene, not for 1 month or 2 months, but as long-term prospectus. Care for our elders, fellow citizens and colleagues should not be phenomenon of bring COVID times, but for years and generations to come. Every little thing accounts in a crisis, emphasizing to the power of people. Abraham Lincoln once said, "I am a firm believer in the people. If given the truth, they can be dependent upon to meet any financial, social, political, and national crisis. The lesson lies in the fact that we shouldn't wait until we are in a crisis to come up with the crisis plan, but preempt it." We can say, in the words of Jawaharlal Nehru, "Crisis and deadlocks, when they occur, have at least the advantages that they forces us to think about it." So that's it for today. Thank you for listening. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. Also, provide your suggestions to improve. Jai Hind, Jai Bharat.